morning, everybody.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thank you so much for changing New York City today. This is going to be, it's going to be a big deal. We're going to get a lot done today. We're going to change a lot of hearts and minds.
We're here today to make a cultural change, but it's going to start with having Albany give New York permission to have a 20 mile per hour speed zone, which we badly need since most deaths occur as a result of speeding. We're also here to get speed cameras.
Speed cameras and reduce speeding in the city of New York, and saving deaths and injuries from cars that have exceeded the limits.
The speed camera program is only operational during school hours. That's a big problem, because 77% of people who are killed in speeding crashes are killed after school hours, in the evening and on weekends.
This is my son, Asif Rahman, and he died in a road accident exactly 6 years ago on Queens Boulevard.
Senator Savisky was one of three elected officials that helped to get daylighting spots for Ali's, the site of Ali's incident. Yeah.
Today I'm wearing Allison's wristband, because we're not only legislators, we're parents. This could happen to anybody. Driving is a very dangerous situation where people have to be careful. And you see the consequences when people don't think.
We encourage all these citizens in New York City to go out into the streets, to ride their bikes, to walk, because it's healthy, and yet they're in danger all the time. We need to lower the speed limits in New York City, and we need to enforce the lowering of those speed limits.
These are some of the family members who've come together as part of our group forum just 4 weeks ago. New York City's transportation policies have prioritized the swift movement of cars, trucks, and buses over the safe use of our streets by motor vehicles, pedestrians, and cyclists.
It has been evidently clear to me that part of the problem here is that the traffic speed limit in the city of New York is quite simply too high. I wear two bracelets, so what do they say if you can't read them? 20 is plenty. And I've now lived that, because now as a person who does have to drive in New York City, I now drive 20 miles an hour. And you know what I've learned? You can get where you need to go by going 20 miles an hour. New York City is a unique place. It's a place where people need to be protected, where bicyclists and pedestrians most particularly.
I'm very proud to be the sponsor in the New York State Senate of Bill 6496, which would allow the city of New York to dictate the speed limit in the city of New York. The five boroughs of the city of New York were consolidated in 1898. I think after 116 years, it is about time that the city of New York be allowed the right to control its speed limit.
My son Seth Kahn was struck, knocked down, run over, and killed by a city bus. He was one of the most careful people you ever want to meet. He was kind, generous, and everybody loved him.
But I understand why this is a difficult bill for some of my members and for a lot of people. They believe that they can safely speed. Even I do. All of us do. We think that we have things under control and that we are able to speed at will and be able to stop. Well, tragedies like the ones you just heard teach us that we're wrong.
We hope you remember our stories and this quote. When you experience opposition, this is a more imperative that you lead New York to a safe street.
I think we got a lot of good feedback from assembly members who are going to be joining the bill. I think we got at least a half dozen people to sign up for the bill. I'm pretty happy with that.
I think we did great. I think we were amazing and impressive and eloquent, and things are happening.
I think we are going to get there. The more we push the envelope, the more we put the information out there, the more the public will be aware. And I believe today was successful.